In this video, let's check out how to recover deleted records from SQL Server database. It is always good to have a recovery plan and make sure that the database backup are taken on a regular basis and are stored safely. This increases database safety and is a safe recovery option when an unprecedented disaster strikes. Regardless of the safety precautions taken, in some instances, the prevention measures do not stop the disaster, and it becomes difficult to recover the database with conventional methods, but there are solutions. A database backup combined with an LDF file is what you need to recover a database without losing any original data. But to recover SQL Server database completely and to ensure that all the changes that have happened can be re-executed after the restoration of full backup, you need to use an advanced software. We bring you the ultimate solution: SysTools SQL Log Analyzer Tool. Install and run the licensed version of our software on your system. In the home screen, you will find user-friendly navigation options. Click Open button on top. A small window opens with advanced options. You can see the online database and offline database options. In this example, let's choose the online database option. In the live database option, you have to enter the server name in the field. After that, in the authentication field, select the Windows authentication option. Then choose the desired database from the drop-down option. Then click OK. The files will be scanned. After the scanning completes, click OK. Now you can see the tables from the selected database will appear on the left. You can click on the desired table to preview its records. Then on the right side, you can see all the transaction details, login name, time, transaction name, etc. from the chosen file. Now check the desired table or tables from the option field on left and click export button on top. Now you can see different export options here. SQL Server database option is selected by default. Then comes the SQL Server compatible SQL scripts option to save files as server compatible scripts. Then comes the CSV option. This option lets you export the log file into CSV format. Now, for example, let's select the SQL Server database option. Below you can see the Create Destination Database option. Selecting this option will export your data into a new database. After that, you have to enter the database credentials like server name and database name, etc. Below you can see options like insert, update, and delete options to read and analyze all transactions. Selecting the insert checkbox will export all the inserted data, and choosing the update option will export all the updated data. Then selecting the delete option will export all the deleted data. The apply date filter checkbox option will let you filter data according to the selected date range. You can select the dates from the drop-down option. Click export button after making the selections. After the export process completes, click OK button. Now, if you want to save the export report in a CSV file, click Yes. After that, select the folder you want to save the export report and click OK. And that's it. You have successfully recovered the SQL database using the transaction log. Log on to the given product page for more details and purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.